called a bomb in a bottle.
They do look nice, but they are a deadly, deadly decorative piece.
Tonight, the danger that could be on your back deck right now.
I end up having to jump off the deck and roll around in the wet grass to put myself out.
Yeah, and they're the new trendy outdoor accessory, but it's what you put in them that could make them a deadly mistake.
Fire pots can ignite unexpectedly and launch flames onto the people all around them. And tonight, one man set on fire is telling News 5, only News 5's Karen Johnson, his story. Karen?
Well, Jack, Brian Thoss is telling a story because he wants all of us to know how dangerous these fire pots can be. He was just sitting on a deck with his friends in Union, Kentucky, when one of them tried to relight a fire pot, and that's when Brian found himself on fire.
There was so much swelling.
Brian Thoss sits in pain, his left leg all bandaged up. Underneath, second and possibly third degree burns. The cause of his injuries, the gel used to fuel this fire pot. His friend Luke was the one filling the pot.
I'm headed about right here, about at that position. And it sucked all the air up in it and collapsed this bottle and shot it right over there.
Right onto Brian, who was sitting about 6 feet away.
All I heard was a whoosh, and it was like a flamethrower being shot correctly at my leg.
It's like napalm. That's all you can say about it.
Brian says the more he patted his burning leg to try and put the fire out, the faster it spread.
So I end up having to jump off the deck and roll around in the wet grass to put myself out.
4 days later, while Brian was in the University Hospital burn unit, the Napa Home and Garden gel fuel was recalled. The Consumer Product Safety Commission says 23 people have been injured in 37 incidents. The gel is marketed as a safe, pourable gel, but attorney David Hoyle, who is representing some of the burn victims, says the problem is the fuel is made up of more than 90% ethyl alcohol.
And so when this product is open, the vapors don't disperse into the ambient air, and if there's an ignition source, the flames can actually follow the trail of vapors.
He believes that is what happened to Brian.
You would never think that something so nice looking could be so dangerous.
And we tried getting answers from Napa, but a spokesman directed me to the news release saying, although the gel burners and fuel come with multiple warnings not to pour fuel into a burning or hot cup, it is apparent that in some instances, users are not heeding these warnings. Also, I did check, and some stores like Kroger still sell fire pots and gels. The gels, though, are a different brand, one that's not part of the recall. However, CPSC tells me it is investigating all brands. Jack.